Hi, I'm Corey Montes, owner of Nesh Limited. Today I want to talk to you about a brand new product that we have on the market. This here is the ergonomic adjustable airbrush grip, or I like to call it the Elev8 grip. So what makes this grip so unique? Well, it's a fully rigid two-piece design that this foregrip slides over an air valve extension that threads onto the air valve on the bottom of the airbrush body. And then you have this rear grip that moves down and back, as well as forwards and backwards at an angle. Also, it has a cutaway design allowing access to the needle chuck in the back portion of the airbrush body. So let me talk about why the adjustability and the ergonomics of this are so important. So as you can see here, it's got a lot of organic contouring. And that basically allows the airbrush to sit in the user's hand like so. The objective of this is you want this rear portion to basically rest on the thin R web space of the user's hand, allowing the airbrush to just rest instead of maintaining a tight grip. Subconsciously, when you're trying to get those real fine details, you're more prone to having a tight grip on here, and that's going to cause cramping in the hand as well as right here on the top of the forearm, which can cause problems later on in life, you know, doing this on a regular basis. So I want to get into what comes in the package. So you're going to get the grip. You're going to get the air valve extension and this fastening nut, as well as an Allen key to set the screws once the rear grip is adjusted. So let me go ahead and demonstrate how this all goes together. So today I'm going to be using my Iwata CMC Plus. And I'm going to mention right here that this airbrush grip is compatible with the new Takumi airbrushes, as well as any gravity-fed airbrush. Also, those that come with the MAC valve, as you can see here, with my HPSB side feed airbrush. It's also compatible with the U-style airbrush holder. This here is a four-brush setup. Now let me get into how this actually goes together. So you're going to take the airbrush here. And as you may notice, I have a little bit of thread tape around the threads that just really creates a nice seal so no air is leaking while you're spraying. So you're going to go ahead and thread this air valve extension onto the air valve here. Then you're going to go ahead, you don't need to tighten it too tight, you don't need spanners or anything. Just going to go ahead and put it on there. You're going to slide this into the foregrip like so. Then you're going to take this fastening nut, you're just going to thread it onto the bottom of this air valve extension. You just want this finger tight. The main objective is just so your airbrush isn't moving around in here. It's not jiggling. If you like that, it's fine. It's fine if it jiggles or if it moves around a little bit. You really don't need to get a spanner out and tighten this too tight. So like I mentioned before, you know, it's compatible with this quick disconnect. That's how I like to spray. You know, when I'm spraying with multiple colors, I'm going to have a color in each one of my airbrushes. I'm going to have my, you know, more detail, my general purpose airbrushes. And then, you know, if I'm spraying a larger background, I'm going to have this on my Iwata Eclipse here. Once you have this, once you have this airbrush and grip all set up, you can move this back. I like to have a little bit of friction on here so that it'll stay in place and say, oh, well, you know, I want the airbrush here. Maybe that feels good to you. Maybe you like it all the way in the base position. Maybe you like it all the way open. Basically, get your setup how you like it. So I like mine down just a hair and just rock back a little bit. Once I get it to that desired position, that feels good to me. So once I get it there, I'm going to go ahead and just tighten up these set screws. Once again, you don't need to over-tighten these. Just enough so that the grip doesn't move on you. The main thing that you want is even pressure in all the screws. Like so. Grip doesn't move. Nice and secure. To me, that's perfectly comfortable. So this works with either a single-handed spraying style, if you will. I like to just rest this rear portion on my thin wire web space, and then I kind of wrap my middle finger around this rounded portion. However, it's also comfortable to wrap my middle finger around this foregrip, this radius area here. Then I just let it rest in my hand, and then I just guide the airbrush with my left hand. There you go. Just rest real comfortably in there, so I don't have to maintain a tight grip while I'm spraying. There you have it. I'm going to do another demonstration on, you know, more in depth, and kind of talk about how it feels while I'm spraying, and, you know, demonstrate some tighter details. I'm going to go ahead and work on this panel next video, so stay tuned.